This video was sponsored by iMobi. They offer helpful software solutions for iPhone and Android users like Phone Rescue, a data rescue software that allows you to recover deleted photos, messages, contacts, and more at the click of a button. Try Phone Rescue today for free by clicking the link in the description. Apple announced iPhone OS 1 at the iPhone keynote on January 9th, 2007, and it was released to the public about 5.5 months later on June 29th. iPhone OS 1 didn't actually have an official name upon release. Apple simply said the iPhone runs a version of OS 10, which was Apple's desktop operating system. iPhone OS 1 introduced all kinds of features, including the iPod app, where you could create playlists, sort your music by albums, artists, and genres, listen to songs, audiobooks and podcasts, and watch videos. The iPhone app allowed you to make calls, add contacts to favorites, and have group chats. It also featured texting, photos, mail, Safari, maps, stocks, and weather. The release of iOS 1.1 added the iTunes Store to the home screen and brought support for the first generation iPod Touch. Version 1.1.3, commonly referred to as the January 08 update, introduced many features to the iPod Touch that iPhone users already enjoyed. This included mail, maps, stocks, weather, and notes. But these extra features came at a cost, since iPod Touch users had to pay $19.95 for the upgrade. Apple said their reason for the $19.95 fee was due to accounting rules. Apparently, it was an accounting requirement that if you upgrade a device that's not on a subscription like the iPhone, you have to charge. The reason why Apple charged $19.95 for the upgrade instead of a lower price isn't clear, since they declined to comment on the issue. In 2010, Apple officially ended support of iPhone OS 1. Apple announced iPhone OS 2 at the iPhone Software Roadmap keynote in March 2008. It was released to the public about 4 months later on July 11th, along with the iPhone 3G. Although iPhone OS 2 was compatible with all iPhone and iPod Touch devices at that time, it was again iPod Touch users who had to pay $9.95 for the upgrade. Not as bad as the previous $19.95 upgrade fee, but it still sucked. iPhone OS 2 added a slew of new language support features, enhancements to mail, contacts and calendars, enterprise improvements, tweaks to the iPod app, and introduced the infamous App Store, which Steve Jobs was initially against, partly because he felt his team didn't have the resources to figure out all the complexities that would be involved in policing third-party app developers. He instead favored the web app approach, until he realized web apps weren't taking off like he expected. At that point, he allowed an iPhone software development kit to be created, which laid the foundation for the App Store that we know and love today. The release of iPhone OS 2.1.1 brought support for the second generation iPod Touch, and support of iPhone OS 2 ended in 2011. Apple announced iPhone OS 3 in March 2009, and it was released to the public about 3 months later on June 17th alongside the iPhone 3GS. Apple did not drop support for any devices with this release, but not all features were available on the original iPhone or iPod Touch. iPhone OS 3 introduced hundreds of new features, including cut, copy, and paste, spotlight search, in-app purchases, push notifications for third-party apps, 11 home screen pages instead of 9, voice control, numeric battery percentage view, and voice memos. The first iPad was introduced along iPhone OS 3.2, and support of iPhone OS 3 ended in 2012. Apple introduced iOS 4 in March 2010, and it was released to the public on June 21st alongside the iPhone 4. With this release, Apple dropped support for the original iPhone and iPod Touch for the first time ever. Also, iOS 4 had limited support for the iPhone 3G and second-gen iPod Touch. They lacked multitasking capabilities and the ability to set a custom home screen wallpaper. It's also the first major iOS release that iPod Touch users did not have to pay for. Some of the features introduced in iOS 4 were multitasking, FaceTime, iBooks, app folders, custom home screen wallpaper, and support for Apple Bluetooth keyboards. The release of iOS 4.2.1 brought compatibility to the original iPad and is the final supported release on the iPhone 3G and second-gen iPod Touch due to major performance issues. The release of iOS 4.3 brought iPad 2 compatibility, and support of iOS 4 ended in 2013. Apple announced iOS 5 on June 6, 2011 at its annual Worldwide Developers Conference event, and it was released to the public on October 12, 2011 alongside the iPhone 4S. Apple did not drop support for any devices with this release, as this had already been done with the release of iOS 4.3 7 months earlier. Some of the features introduced in iOS 5 were Notification Center, Newsstand, Reminders, Twitter integration, built-in photo editing in the Photos app, tabbed Safari browsing, Safari Reader, iCloud, Game Center, PC Free Activation, and Siri, which was technically in beta during the entire lifetime of iOS 5. The release of iOS 5.1 brought support for the third-gen iPad, and iOS 5.1.1 was the final release that supported the original iPad and third-gen iPod Touch. Support of iOS 5 was ended in 2014. Apple announced iOS 6 on June 11, 2012 at its annual WWDC event, and it was released to the public on September 19th alongside the iPhone 5. With this release, Apple dropped support for the third-gen iPod Touch and the original iPad due to hardware limitations, and iOS 6 had limited support on the iPhone 3GS, iPad 2, and fourth-gen iPod Touch. Some of the features introduced in iOS 6 were Facebook integration, Passbook, shared photo streams, Do Not Disturb mode, Apple Maps, FaceTime calls over cellular networks, a new App Store user interface, a new iTunes Store user interface, a new weather user interface, removal of the stock YouTube app, panorama mode in the camera app, and lost mode. iOS 6.1.6 is the final release supported for the iPhone 3GS and iPod Touch. iOS 6.1.6 is the final release supported for the iPhone 3GS and 4th-gen iPod Touch, and support of iOS 6 ended in 2015. Apple announced iOS 7 on June 10, 2013 at its annual Apple Worldwide Developers Conference event, and it was released to the public on September 18th alongside the iPhone 5C and iPhone 5S. With this release, Apple dropped support for the iPhone 3GS due to hardware limitations and dropped support for the 4th-gen iPod Touch due to performance issues. All other devices were supported. However, iOS 7 had limited support on the iPad 2 and the iPhone 4 since they did not support Siri. Some of the features introduced in iOS 7 were a completely redesigned user interface where Apple moved away from skeuomorphism toward a cleaner, flatter design. Control Center, AirDrop, dynamic wallpapers, live images, FaceTime audio, the option for a male Siri voice, Find My iPhone, and Vimeo and Flickr integration were also included. The release of iOS 7.0.3 brought support for the iPad Air and iPad Mini 2. iOS 7.1.2 is the final release on the iPhone 4, and support of iOS 7 ended in 2016. Apple announced iOS 8 on June 2, 2014, and it was released to the public on September 17th alongside the iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus. With this release, Apple dropped support for only one device, the iPhone 4, but iOS 8 had limited support on the iPad 2, iPhone 4S, and the 5th-gen iPod Touch. Apple received widespread complaints from owners of these devices due to extremely poor device performance. Some of the features introduced in iOS 8 were iCloud Photo Library, iCloud Drive, app bundles, voice message support in the Messages app, a Do Not Disturb option in group texts, FaceTime audio conference calls, flyover city tours and maps, Shazam integration with Siri, third-party keyboards, a health app, and continuity. The release of iOS 8.1 brought support for the iPad Air 2 and iPad Mini 3, and the release of iOS 8.4 brought support for the 6th-gen iPod Touch. iOS 8.3 was also the first version of iOS to have public beta testing be available. The final version of iOS 8 is iOS 8.4.1, and support for iOS 8 ended in 2017. Apple announced iOS 9 on June 8, 2015, and it was released to the public on September 16th alongside the iPhone 6S, 6S Plus, and iPad Mini 4. With this release, Apple did not drop support for any iOS devices. This release made the iPad 2 the first iOS device to support six major releases of iOS, iOS 4 to 9. However, iOS 9 had limited support on the iPad 2, 3rd-gen iPad, 1st-gen iPad Mini, 5th-gen iPod Touch, and iPhone 4S. Despite Apple's promise of better performance on these devices, there were still widespread complaints that the issue had not been fixed. Some of the features introduced in iOS 9 were CarPlay, Find My Friends, public transit support in Maps, screenshots and selfie albums in the Photos app, the Wallet app which replaced Passbook, low power mode, iPad experience improvements, and expanded language support. iOS 9.3.5 was the final release on the iPhone 4S, iPad 2, 3rd-gen iPad, 5th-gen iPod Touch, and original iPad Mini. Apple announced iOS 10 on June 13, 2016, and it was released 3 months later on September 13th alongside the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus. With this release, Apple dropped support for devices using an A5 or A5X processor, which was the iPhone 4S, iPad 2, 3rd-gen iPad, original iPad Mini, and 5th-gen iPod Touch. Also, iOS 10 had limited support on the iPhone 5, 5C, and 4th gen iPad, since those devices had 32-bit processors. Some of the features introduced in iOS 10 were hiding of most stock apps, new sounds for keyboard clicks and device locking, expressive messaging, iMessage apps, maps extensions, face and object recognition in photos, memories, the Home app, Apple News, Race to Wake, voicemail transcription, and Apple Pay in Safari. The release of iOS 10.2.1 brought support for the 5th gen iPad, and iOS 10.3.2 brought support for the 2nd gen iPad Pros. iOS 10.3.3 is the final supported release for the iPhone 5, 5C, and 4th gen iPad, and the last iOS version to run on 32-bit processors. Apple announced iOS 11 on June 5, 2017, and it was released for download on September 19th alongside the iPhone 8 and 8 Plus. This is the first version of iOS to be exclusively available to 64-bit devices that only ran 64-bit apps. Also, iOS 11 has limited support on devices with an A7 processor. Some of the features introduced in iOS 11 are a redesigned App Store, a more natural voice for Siri, Siri language translation, indoor maps for major airports and shopping centers, do not disturb while driving, markup, files, and augmented reality. As of this video, iOS 11 is the most recent version, but rumors of iOS 12 are everywhere in the Apple community. Let me know in the comments what new feature you'd like to see in iOS 12, and thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.